Hello, I'm JW. Today we have this piece of flex here with a plug on the end. And this is the one from that solder pot, which we did a couple of videos on a while ago. And it's the one with that sort of Chinese-y type plug on the end where the earth pin isn't particularly well connected to anything. The flex, which claims to be 0.5 square millimetres, but may or may not be that size, but in reality it's some kind of copper-coated aluminium or some other unusual metal. And also the colours inside were a bit off. I mean, they're near, but certainly not what you call brown and blue. And the earth one is sort of more orange than yellow. So what we're going to do with this then is take it outside and connect it up to a substantial amount of current and see if it melts or sets on fire or explodes in a big ball of flames. And we've got on the end here just a great gobs of solder. That's again from the previous video where we just shoved that in the molten vat of solder to show that it was actually molten. So let's take this outside and see what we can do with it. So here's the wire. I've just shoved the three cores into the other clip at the back there, and just going to apply the other end to the pins of the plug, and current shown in the background. So fairly low setting at the moment, about 12 amps or so. Some difficulty in the connection here, but as you can see, passes the 12 amps no problem, and it's not melting or setting on fire. So for the purposes this was designed for, which was that sort of 1 amp or so solder pot, then probably not a major problem. Now let's check the temperature of that. It is warm, but certainly not melting or causing any kind of damage. So anyway, let's crank up the power to a more sensible level and then see what happens this time. So we're set to about 35 amps there, and see a lot of smoke pouring out of the ends and various other components of it there. So pretty obviously that's rather overloading. And you see it's just failed. That's actually failed at the back connector there, where one of the wires has just broken off or melted through. So that certainly didn't last long. But that's really not good enough, so I'll attempt to reconnect it, and then we'll have another attempt. So back on with the wire there, I'll just shove the wires back together, and hopefully we can get a bit more current going through this time. So 32 watt amps going through, and as you can see, it's melting and smoking quite vigorously. And once again, the flames have appeared at the end as something sparked and ignited the toxic gases being given off. And it's totally open circuit now, as you can see there. So that's pretty much the end of that. There you have the cable in this sort of disgusting, rubbery, melted mess. So doubtful that that's going to be working again. And yeah, totally open circuit there, so no connection whatsoever. So they said the clamp meter has now fallen down, and now it's actually just starting to rain as well. So that really concludes the destruction of this piece of flex. So although it wasn't actually copper inside, it would have done the job with the, say, 1 amp fuse or 2 amp fuse in that solder pot thing. But of course that plug is no good for the UK anyway, and clearly it would have been have to be replaced with a UK one anyway. And the wires of that style, which is really difficult to actually twist together, so it's pretty obviously not copper. It's obviously some sort of aluminium or other non-copper metal. So that's pretty much it for this one. So there was no real point to this, other than just to destroy the piece of flex. And well, I'll just put all this stuff away. It just remains to say thanks for watching.